it's Christmas time. It's almost Christmas time, and I'm trying to do a better job of actually getting gifts out to people on time this year. Usually I only really get gifts from my family, and I usually don't get those gifts to them until December 30th. Partially, it started because like I didn't have the money to buy gifts at first, and then within the last few years, it's just been, I've been busy, I've been lazy, and then Christmas gets here, and I'm like,
oh, I guess it's time.
And this year, I've like fully discovered online shopping more than ever before. The pandemic has definitely like forced that on me a little bit, and so I did a lot of Christmas shopping on Amazon, but also on eBay, as you can maybe see by this relic behind me. So my dad had a record player growing up. We played the Jackson, young Michael Jackson, and Jackson 5, I don't know. We played some record with Michael Jackson on it all the time growing up, and just realized recently that that record player is no longer at our house, but our dad still has a lot of records and doesn't play them. So wanted to try and do something, and he's just very difficult to shop for in general. So it's always an interesting kind of task to figure out what we're gonna get him for Christmas. Usually it's sweatshirts or sweatpants or jeans or a polo shirt that he can wear when we go out to eat. So anyways, this year we're going to try and do a record player, which is what this masterwork solid state situation is behind me. He mentioned, I haven't like directly asked what kind of records do you have or blah blah blah, but I do remember him saying one time that he has 16s and a lot of record players don't play those records anymore. So that is what brought me to eBay. That is what brought me to eBay. So this has 16 rotations per minute. It can play those vinyls as well as, I think it's 33, 48, and then also 70 something. And a lot of the ones that are made new today by like Urban Outfitters and different things like that look really nice, but only have those either two or three more common speeds. So this one has four. As you can see, it's vintage. You can see, but there's definitely some scuffing, some scratching of the finish on the top. This blue is not ideal, but overall it's a good machine. This is where the sound comes out. These are volume control. This is the power. So I'm gonna do a DIY. I have some paint. So I got, I don't know if you can see this, it's gonna be flat black. So hopefully, you know, there might be some footage of the reaction when my dad gets it, though he, like myself, isn't a huge reactor to things. He'll probably be like,
oh, okay. Oh, where'd you get that?
And that'll be it, but we'll see.
It's Christmas time in the city.
And now for the reveal. So you'll see some of the damage. These are the pictures from eBay, but there were some issues pointed out with these red arrows that weren't covered with just regular paint. So in the reveal, you can see that I was able to cover those up. I used some Mod Podge and mixed it in with the paint and then put another layer of just Mod Podge by itself over everything so that it will have a little protection, get rid of some of that weird texture that was there, and just have more of a smooth finish. So here she is. Unfortunately, I did not get any footage of my dad opening his gift. I think my mom has it on her phone, but she took a 30-minute-ish video and she's not able to text it. So it's not gonna be here, but here's some other Christmas footage. And you'll hear how I introduced the gift to my dad, even though you can't see anything because I'm apparently an 80-year-old woman who doesn't know how to use her cell phone.
This is vintage though, so you gotta wiggle the plug so you can make it work right. Don't be mad if it doesn't play.
I wish I could say the story ended there and it was just a holly jolly Christmas, good times. But there's a little more to the story that happened over the course of the next few days.
My old friend.
Okay. So basically, my dad really liked the record player. First day, he went back to all the records he had back in his room and tried to start playing them. One of the albums I got was a little scratchy, but he said, no, it's probably just the album. It's old and that's just how they get. He was being very nice. But then he started to play his own albums and there were some issues. Nothing too crazy. It just kind of seemed like that's what old records sound like. But then the next day, so the day after Christmas, I wake up and my dad's in my room at my family home and he's like, come see what this thing's doing back here. And he had a toothbrush on the arm that plays. And he said that basically the arm was moving around, not really doing what it needed to do to actually play. And so he had to put a weight on it. So he put a toothbrush on it so that it would play like it needed to play. So I was like, oh, okay, well, that's not great, but at least he can fix it, it'll work. And then maybe a few hours later, I get up and go back there again, and he's like, listen to this. And you could barely hear anything coming out of that record player. And at that point, I was like, okay, yeah, I'll order another one off of Amazon. Now that I know you don't need these special 16s record player, I'll just get you a new one that will work just fine. You won't have any issues with it. You won't have to be Mr. Fix-It, whatever. So I ordered a new one off of Amazon. That's the one that you saw here. It's really nice. I'll put pictures up so you can see it just in all of its glory. So that came in. He really liked it. It played a lot more loudly than the original one. It wasn't scratchy. There weren't any issues. But I will say, by the time the new one came, my dad had a few days to tinker around with the original one I got from eBay, and he actually got it to work fine. He didn't have to have a toothbrush on it anymore. The sound ended up playing fine, and he said that there was an issue with some of the wires under like the needle arm, whatever it's called, and he was able to like reconnect those and it's working fine. So I have it here in my home now. I might use it. I don't have any vinyls right now, so if anyone's interested, I have a vintage, newly refinished record player here that I would be willing to part with if you're interested. So yeah, all in all, I think it was the gift went well. My dad, the day I came back up to Alexandria, he went to the record store and was looking for new things. He was cleaning some of his old records so he could keep playing them. So I think he's really happy about it. I think he seems really happy about it. And I think just in general, it was a really good day, a really good Christmas for my whole family. So I am happy. We did it. Finally, 2020. I did not fail at Christmas, so I feel good about that. And I will leave you all with one final clip of my mom opening one of her gifts for Christmas. She's also notoriously hard to shop for any holiday or any gift-giving event. So here's a clip of her reacting to one of the gifts she opened. And I will leave you with that. Thank you for watching my video and hopefully see you next time.
Don't tear. What is it? What is it? This white thing is in my video.
Chocolate.
It's Rosie's.
All right. Woo!
And then you will win. You'll win $1 million.